On March 9th, it was validated that the F-35 fifth generation fighter jet is now officially equipped to carry the B61-12 nuclear gravity bombs. This significant advancement means it's the first time such a capability has been made possible for a Western multi-role stealth fighter. The F-35A has been fully certified to carry the B61-12 thermonuclear bomb. F-35. As being able to deliver nuclear strikes will add major credibility to NATO's nuclear deterrence posture in Europe. The aircraft's unique ability to pierce enemy air defense networks and defend itself on the way to its target will be a standing capability Russia has never had to deal with. The F-117 was capable of delivering nuclear strikes. It could have been called upon to do so, but that was not part of its normal mission purview, and the aircraft remained deeply classified during the tail end of the Cold War, complicating its use in such a role and its deterrence value. You can read more about this in our special feature here. The F-35's added survivability will complicate Moscow's ability to defend against these strikes, and whatever predictive modelling they have on the probability of those strikes succeeding will have to be adjusted accordingly. This capability can also be used in other theatres, including the Korean Peninsula and the wider Pacific region. But there isn't a similar standing tactical nuclear weapons delivery mission there as there is in Europe. A spokesman from the F-35 Joint Program Office, JPO, Russ Gomer, said yesterday that the certification was achieved on October 12th, according to a report from Breaking Defense. The milestone was achieved earlier than planned. The US Air Force had previously announced that it aimed to have the F-35A certified to carry the B61-12 by January 2024. It's unclear at this stage whether a decision was made to bring the F-35's nuclear certification forward. Whatever the case, in light of the increasing tensions between Russia and NATO, adding this capability to the alliance's existing deterrence forces is a significant development. The F-35A is the first fifth-generation nuclear-capable aircraft ever, and the first new platform, fighter or bomber, to achieve this status since the early 1990s, Gomer said. This F-35 nuclear certification effort culminates 10-plus years of intense effort across the nuclear enterprise, which consists of 16 different government and industry stakeholders, Gomer added. Contrary to some previous reports, the F-35A doesn't require the Block 4 upgrade to use the B61-12. This is good news for the Joint Strike Fighter enterprise, amid ongoing delays and difficulties with Block 4, as well as the Technology Refresh 3, TR-3 hardware and software suite, on which this new standard relies. The US Air Force says it plans for all of its F-35As to be in a nuclear-certified configuration in the future, independent of their assigned lot number. However, while the individual aircraft may ultimately all become DCA-certified, it doesn't mean that all will actually have a nuclear role. Only specifically designated squadrons will actually have the qualifications and infrastructure to fly nuclear strike missions, as well as access to the bombs themselves. One of the US Air Force units that seemingly will have nuclear-rolled F-35. A's is the 48th fighter wing at RAF Lakenheath in England. There have been increasing hints that the United Kingdom will host US-owned tactical nuclear bombs again after the last examples were withdrawn from there in 2008. You can read all about the implications of this change here. Generally, however, there remains much more secrecy about the status of the B61-12 bombs that will provide the F-35A's nuclear payload. As of 2023, the Federation of American Scientists assessed that there were likely around 100 of the legacy B61-3 and B61-4 bombs deployed in Europe, where they are available for the US Air Force as well as certain Allied air forces, under a NATO nuclear sharing agreement arrangement. Ultimately, it's planned for these older bombs to be replaced by the much-improved B61-12, although the status of this effort remains a closely guarded secret. The aforementioned Dutch, as well as Belgium, Germany and Italy, are all currently operating DCAs in Europe, and are expected to continue the mission in the future using F-35As. In the case of Germany, the nuclear capability of the aircraft was a central driver behind its being acquired in the first place. Deployment of the B61-12 in Europe is an issue that we have also discussed in the past. One possible indicator of the B61-12 being fielded in Europe could again come from the Dutch. The RNLAF has said it expects to declare full operational capability with its F-35As in early 2024. This declaration means the fighter can carry out all of the missions previously assigned to Dutch F-16S, including the DCA mission. What we do know about the B61-12 relates above all to its capabilities, including a new guidance package based on an inertial navigation system, INS, and a precision guidance tail kit. Measuring 12 feet long and weighing 825 pounds, the B61-12 notoriously costs more than its weight in gold. At the same time, it's not an entirely new weapon, with each example also including refurbished components from earlier B61-3, -4, -7, and -10 variants. While nuclear tasked, FF-35, as will only be able to carry B61-12S wherever they are based, a somewhat different situation faces some of the other DCA types operated by NATO in Europe, which won't be able to make full use of the new weapons capabilities. In 2022, the US Air Force confirmed to the war zone that there were no plans for US Air Force or NATO F-16 fighters or German or Italian Panavia Tornado strike jets to be able to leverage the precision guidance tail kit that is a signature part of the B61-12. At that time, the requirement was only to integrate that particular functionality on US Air Force F-15E Strike Eagle combat jets, also based in Europe, and B-2A Spirit stealth bombers, as well as the service's forthcoming B-21 Raider stealth bombers, in addition to nuclear-tasked US Air Force and NATO F-35As. This makes the nuclear tasking of DCA F-35As in Europe all the more important, since they will be able to use the B61-12 to the full extent of its capabilities. Aside from that, the F-35A becoming the first stealth fighter to be certified to carry a nuclear weapon of any kind is a big deal. But with the changing strategic environment in Europe, it seems likely that the news will be seen, especially in Moscow, in terms of NATO's increasingly strained relationship with Russia. The situation has even prompted officials in Poland to say they want to join NATO's nuclear weapons sharing program. Were that to happen, the F-35A would be the obvious delivery platform candidate. Regardless of when the B61-12 arrives in Europe, the US Air Force and nuclear sharing allies that fly the F-35A are now officially in possession of a stealth fighter with a unique ability to penetrate enemy air defenses and to do so with a nuclear payload.